What type of paint's best for your metal roof? Today, industry experts from Valspar make an appearance on Q&A Mondays to answer some questions. Hi, I'm Thad Barnette from SHEFFIELD Metals, and welcome to the Metal Roofing Channel. We are here for another Q&A Monday, and I've got Rick Afton and Jeff Alexander from Valspar on call with me. Thanks for joining me today, guys.
No problem with that. Thanks.
So first, tell me a little bit about yourselves and your experience in the industry, please.
Thad, I'm Jeff Alexander, and I'm the Vice President of Sales for Valspar's Coil Coating Division, and I've been at Valspar for 21 years, and prior to that, I was in the steel industry, and I was in the steel industry for 11 years.
All right, Rick.
Yeah, this is Rick Afton. I've been in the coil coating business and the technical side of things for 41 years. I'm located out of Bowling Green, Kentucky now. I've dealt with both research, development, innovation, and now in management as the Global Technical Director for Valspar Coil and Extrusion.
So today we're going to be talking about Kynar versus SMP. So why don't you guys tell me a little bit about each and the differences of each?
First of all, Thad, I want to clear up something, kind of a misnomer on Kynar. Kynar itself is not a paint. It is a trade name, a registered trademark for a resin. And so with that, I'll tell you a little bit about the two of them. Kynar is the resin called PVDF, or polyvinylidene difluoride. It is used in combination with acrylics to make coatings that we refer to as a general category as PVDF. SMP, on the other hand, is an acronym for siliconized modified polyester, and it is also a very good coating for weathering. And when you look at the two paints themselves and what they offer, both of these types of coatings are considered premium coatings for performance, outside weathering, and so forth. PVDF, if you look at it from the standpoint of good, better, best, PVDF is generally looked at as the best coatings, followed closely by the better coatings, which would be the SMP, or siliconized modified polyester.
Why is SMP used more in agricultural applications than PVDF?
So the ag panel market, from a square footage basis, is much larger than the PVDF market space would be. Broader applications ranging from some residential roofing to typical agricultural type buildings. The reason SMP is used in these spaces, generally you have less dynamic, more brilliant colors. They tend to be a little more of the typical standard color offing of whites, tans, light stones, ash gray, some greens, but the super bright colors generally are not going into this market space. Those colors would tend to go the PVDF route versus the siliconized polyester route. The siliconized polyester coatings tend to be harder, a little more scratch resistant. So that situation plays well into the ag panel market as well.
You know, I did want to kind of elaborate on the word hardness. We think of, as Jeff said, scratch resistance and that sort of thing. There is a significant difference between the two chemistries. PVDF tends to be more flexible and less hard, as we said, and SMPs tend to be a little bit less flexible and harder. When you're forming the panels, both for commercial and ag, the SMP product tends to work better because of both the ratio of hardness and flexibility. There are situations, like Jeff mentioned, where the bright color spaces, that, and in the bright color spaces, things like bright red or various types of blues or bright greens, those kinds of colors generally are reserved for our use with PVDFs rather than SMPs, just because of that, as I mentioned earlier, the good, better, best. So you want the best weathering type coatings with those pigment combinations for the brightness and space. Ag buildings are not that bright normally, as Jeff mentioned, more of the earth tones and those kinds of.
So for brighter colors, you want the best option for fading characteristics.
And also, Thad, a lot of the PVDF product goes into roofing. The siliconized polyester products, while roofing is certainly included, tend to be the sidewall panels, a little less exposure to UV.
How about in commercial applications? Is there a difference with SMP and PVDF used in commercial applications?
Building on the last question, we get a number of, there are a number of color requests that go into the commercial monumental building area. And these requests typically have a very high percentage of unique colors. These are for architects that want to have a special color for their building, or a special texture, or a special metallic look. So there tends to be a lot more metallics and those special colors for these buildings. And the color space for the commercial monumental buildings tends to be more of a one-off or a specific job-related color or texture or metallic. We don't talk about metallics very often at all with SMPs, but we talk about metallics very frequently with PVDFs because of these monumental buildings and these commercial buildings that you asked about. Mm-hmm. So the color space is much wider when you're looking at the commercial building area.
Well, I agree with you. And I do think it does come back to vertical versus non-vertical on choice also. We see a lot of the PVDF used for roofing and other non-vertical applications, and partly due to the weathering capabilities of the PVDF and also due to color selection.
You know, one thing I didn't say earlier, and I need to say it, is we have exposures on the fence of PVDF where we put them out in South Florida, and we have exposures that date back 50 years.
Wow, okay.
So 50 years of time with PVDF, and they still have color and gloss and integrity and that sort of thing. Those are the longest panels that I've seen out there on the fence. And it speaks pretty highly of that technology.
Are there any other kind of testing methods used other than long exposure panels?
When qualifying any paint system, any coating system, there's a rigorous set of testing that goes on, both physical type testing and then accelerated weathering or accelerated humidity testing, those kinds of tests. Typically, those are done at the beginning of a project, and so you know what the process is or what the results will tend to be for any particular platform of chemistry.
And I would say that while the PVDF chemistry has been around for a long time, certainly in our case, we've made great improvements to the entire formulation. And also there's a whole generation of effect and texturized types of PVDF coatings out that we have now that are certainly becoming more and more popular. So while the base technology has been around for a long time, a lot of improvements and modifications and effect type appearances have been made to it to make it even more attractive to the architectural market space, mm-hmm. To residential roofing, right. And some of the commercial markets.
So is there, what in addition to appearance have been made as far as improvements go?
Rick, go ahead.
I think to build on what Jeff's saying and what you're asking, Thad, our trade name for our PVDF is Fluoropon. The Fluoropon family, however, Jed, has numerous parts to the family. We have a textured four pound, for instance, that we didn't have in the early days, right? We have various types of gloss ranges, various types of metallic versions. We have a couple of new products where we're using chemistry that gives you a very highly shimmering look when you look at the colors. So the unique appearances portion to these chemistries have come a long way in the last 5 years or so. In the case of SMP, the same in some cases where we have what we call a crinkle coating. It is micro wrinkled / textured coating, which brings a whole new element to roofs perhaps made with this type of SMP.
Right.
A kind of a muted gloss and yet a very traditional type shingle appearance that some of the other coatings don't have. So we have come a long way in the areas of, as Jeff said, appearance or effects type coatings.
So these are all different types of formulations. So there's not just a single PVDF choice. Is that correct? And there's not just a single SMP choice.
That would be correct. Yeah, I refer to the PVDF and the SMP as platforms. So it's okay. A platform. And then you've got subsets in the platform.
Yeah, and I think that's a really good way to describe that, because I think that's another misnomer out there that there's one choice for each.
Yeah, and when you're looking at roofs, like Jeff mentioned earlier, when you're looking at roofs and you're thinking besides the weathering, which we understand is a core to that to the need there. But there's a reflectivity too for people like they're flying planes over roofs, and a more muted, lower gloss kind of a roof tends to be a very positive thing from the standpoint of safety for those people going over the roof. So it's even more than just the look; it's the whole package. I think it should be said, and Jeff, you can elaborate on this, but. SMPs generally is a coating area we continue to try to make improvements to. In other words, we're basically in our business on our third generation of an SMP. We had a Coilclad 10S that went for 21 years, and then we had something called WeatherX, and now we're WeatherX L. So we continue to look for improvements for the SMP chemistry. PVDF really stands on its own merits. It is 30% acrylic and 70% PVDF, and there's not a lot of improvements that you can make on something that weathers for 50 years. So that's why in that area we tend to do more of the effects or color space or those. Jeff, do you have any input to that too?
Well, I would say that we have expanded our color spaces in SMP and somewhat PVDF also due to the technology gains in pigmentation. We make some of our own colorants, but we rely on our suppliers to bring us innovation in that area as well. So we've expanded into color spaces, warrantable color spaces that a few years ago we would not have been able to warrant those colors. So that's an important advancement also.
Yeah, and one last thing, too, that we haven't covered, that is the area of solar reflectance. And this, of course, is a big item now and has been growing over the past probably 12 years or so. We try to make sure that we give the best solar reflectivity emissivity type coatings that we can for the colors that are requested. And when I talk about that, that gets into energy savings, groups like Energy Star and LEED and Green Build and those kinds of organizations are very interested about this kind of process. So we attempt on all color matches coming in these two areas to make them solar reflective approved.
Yeah, good point. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap us up here, guys. I think we've had a really good conversation. Any last things that you guys want to say before we close?
Well, I'd just like to thank you and thank Sheffield Metals for all the great support that you've shown us, and hopefully we've shown it back, and it's been a great partnership for a really long time. So thanks a lot.
Yeah, I appreciate Jeff and Rick coming on the show for sure. Comment below with any questions, subscribe to the Metal Roofing Channel, and as always, I'm Thad Barnette from Sheffield Metals, and I'll catch you next time.